I majored in immunology and infection, but that wasn't actually my first choice. Let me tell you why. So during the last undergrad year, being the third bachelor year, we had to decide on which project to pick for our thesis in the master years. And the system that my university used was that you pick the project which outweighs the courses you get along with the project and which major is attached to it. What was always highlighted is the versatility that a biomedical graduate should have. If he would major in a field like, for instance, immunology, he should also have the capacity to quickly learn and adapt and get into tissue engineering, for instance. So you get a list of 10 projects and attached to that is a major. So you get to choose 10 projects out of a whole list of projects, but you can't cheat and pick all the projects in the major you want. So I go along and I fill in 7 projects on tissue engineering and stem cell research, 2 projects on neuroscience, and 1 project on immunology and infection. What turned out? I got the immunology one. And at first I was bummed a bit because I wanted to get into tissue engineering and stem cell research, and on top of that, immunology and infection was the major that had the reputation of being the most labor intensive. But all in all, I was very grateful and perhaps maybe lucky that I landed in that major, because I ended up with a lot of skills out of that immunology major. Also guys, want to take a second here. If you like my content, please hit that like button, subscribe, share the channel with people that you think might benefit from it, your fellow classmates, maybe people that want to get into biomedical science but they don't know quite what it's about yet. Subscribe, share the channel to anyone who think might benefit from it. Immunology and infection is a major that's all about the immune system and pathogens, how the immune system functions molecularly, and how it dysfunctions in a pathology case, like for instance rheumatoid arthritis, Crohn's disease, ulcerative colitis, COPD for the lungs, asthma, disease states like that. And infections, of course, I don't think I have to explain this, bacterial infections, fungal infections, viral infections, like COVID-19 for instance. What about you guys? If you're watching this, what do you think about a major in biomedical science in immunology and infection? Would you choose this one over other majors? What's your opinion? Let me know in the comments. Which courses did I get during my immunology major? 1, molecular immunology. 2, molecular virology. 3, molecular bacteriology. 4, immunopathology. So these are 4 courses that I got in the first year of my master's. And then 5, vaccinology. This course I got in the second master's. The content of these courses actually speak for themselves, I guess. But what was very interesting is the way they were taught. See, if you're in a grad year, in a master year, you don't just get courses handed over and here's the stuff you have to learn and start memorizing. No, they try to incorporate it in a hands-on, practical experience. For instance, in molecular virology, besides a part of theory, we also had to sort of like take articles with a certain experimental outline and had to come up with a research project that would follow up on that article. So this is really hands-on training where you start to think about how to write a grant application, how to figure out new research. Another example, in the molecular bacteriology course, we had to teach each other. So we had to make a course ourselves on a certain bacterium that we thought was interesting and teach that in a lecture of 50 minutes to the classmates. And then molecular immunology consisted of tons of technological exposure to certain techniques like qPCR, cell culturing, isolating PBMCs, really a lot of hands-on training in the lab. And that's really the purpose of grad years, like doing a master's, is get more into that hands-on experience in the lab, in a true research setting. So to apply the theory that you've learned in your undergrad. One book that I bought that really helped me out, so I bought the book during my undergrad year, somewhere the second year, second bachelor year. This is this one, Immunobiology by Janeways, and it helped out majorly in my major of immunology and infection. So if there's one book that I'd recommend to understand the immune system, then it's
this one.
You might be wondering then what my thesis project was about, as it was linked to the immunology majors, but I didn't want to choose it per se. I was interested in the topic because it employed nanobodies in a cancer context. And if you've seen my book video that I released recently, I'll put a link right here. One of the first phrases that I mentioned when I showed the book The Chronicles of Cancer is that I'm also interested in cancer biology. And the project was about nanobody technology in the context of cancer. What's the link with immunology? Well, nanobodies are a small fragment of a heavy chain only antibody that's only found in the camelid species, llamas, dromedaries. These are single domain antibodies. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I have a video separately discussing nanobody technology. You can view it after this video right here. So guys, that's how my major in immunology was structured, which thesis project that I took on. I hope you can find this useful, maybe to base yourself on which major you should take to graduate in your own biomedical course. Thank you so much for watching. As always, like, subscribe, share, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers!